Medical Tourism Corporation Network's India surrogacy expert, talks about legal indications for commercial surrogacy in India.
What are the common indications for surrogacy? Well, they could be single men, gay male couples. Actually, 50% of our clientele now is single men and gay male couples, like from Scandinavia, from Australia, from, you know, because this is the only country in the world where they are allowed surrogacy legally with the least of hassles, and their consulates just give them the passport at the end to take the babies back. Heterosexual couples, basically, we had a lot of requests in late 2007 and early 2008, me and some other clinics from USA mainly, where women just wanted to do surrogacy to, you know, sometimes it was very embarrassing. They said, we don't have time and we want to get surrogacy done. So the Indian government got hold of some women's organizations, got hold of some of these letters and requests, and now in the amended draft they make it very clear that surrogacy in India will be offered only to women who are genuinely incapable of carrying a child to term, either due to physical disability, or a psychiatrist has to certify that the only recourse is gestational surrogacy. Because we've had a patient from USA who had a peculiar syndrome. She had a phobia to pregnancy. Whenever a couple from abroad comes, we need two documents. One is either their RE gives us a letter that they have attempted surrogacy four times, attempted IVF three, four times, and it's implantation failure. That's the most straightforward thing. Or for whatever is the indication, or we get a letter from the psychiatrist saying that gestational surrogacy is the only thing. The other letter, which in late 2008 the health ministry in India wants, is a letter on your letterhead saying that you have talked to the respective consulate in Bombay, you are planning to do surrogacy, and it is your responsibility, the husband and wife's responsibility, of taking the baby back home. This is because of this baby manji thing. They want this letter, and this letter has to be notarized. It could be notarized either here from a lawyer, or when you come to Bombay, the lawyer takes 500 rupees and notarizes it there. But this letter is essential before we begin the process. LSCS, again, I'm asked this question in the West whenever I lecture, that is it going to be a cesarean section every time? And LSCS is only for obstetric indications. 95%+ of patients, surrogates have delivered vaginally, normal. It's only if there is an obstetric indication is a cesarean section going to be done. Usually these surrogates all have 2-3 children of their own. So by and large, they have very easy deliveries. In a couple of hours, they deliver them.
Medical Tourism Corporation facilitates affordable medical and dental treatment at world-class international hospitals and clinics. Fill out the estimate request form on our site, medicaltourismco.com, for a free quote and more information.